Hello everyone, in the last lecture I have covered the theory part of the HSFG bolt. So in this lecture we will solve an analytical problem related to HSFG bolt. Okay, so the question says two plates of 12 mm thick are joined by double cover bolt joint with 20 mm HSFG bolts of property class 8.8 and cover plates of 8 mm thick. Assuming that the fasteners are in clearance holes and slip factor as 0.3, then determine shear capacity of bolt. If the first condition is slip resistance is designed at service load, then the second condition is slip resistance is designed at ultimate load. Okay. So, it is clear that this is the case of the double cover bolt joint. That means, here you can see these two main plates are aligned end to end each other and they are joined by the help of two cover plates. One cover plate is at the top and another cover plate is at the bottom. Okay. And the next thing is two plates of 12 mm thick. That means here the thickness of main plate is 12 mm and the thickness of the cover plate is 8 mm. Okay. So, here you can see the thickness of the main plate is 12 mm and the thickness of cover plates is 8 mm. Then next thing is with 20 mm HSFG bolts, that means it is the case of high strength friction grip bolted joint. Means here the bolt is the HSFG bolt, not the bearing bolt. Okay. And the property class of the bolt is 8.8. Okay. So, the property class of the HSFG bolt is 8.8. Means I have already discussed that from the property class of bolt we can get the value of the ultimate tensile strength of the bolt. So here this 8 stands for 1/100 into ultimate tensile strength of the bolt. Okay, so here the ultimate tensile strength of the bolt will be 8 × 100, that is 800 MPa or Newton per mm square. Okay, so given data are here FUB is 800 MPa, that you can get from the property class of the bolt, and here the property class of HSFG bolt is 8.8. Okay, so here 8 stands for 1/100 into ultimate tensile strength of bolt. So FUB is 8 × 100, that is 800 MPa, and the diameter of the bolt is 20 mm here. Okay, so the diameter of HSFG bolt is 20 mm. Then assuming that the fasteners are in clearance holes, means this is the condition for the value of KH. So for the fasteners in clearance hole, the value of KH is 1. Okay, so you can refer the clause number 10.4.3 to get the value of KH for different conditions. So there are three conditions for the value of KH. So here one condition is that the fasteners are in clearance holes. So for this condition the value of KH is 1. The next is, and slip factor as 0.3, that means the coefficient of friction or the slip factor, this value is given in the question directly, that is 0.3. Okay. Then it is asked to determine the shear capacity of bolt if the slip resistance is designed at service load and if the slip resistance is designed at ultimate load. Okay. So we have to calculate the design shear capacity or the slip resistance of HSFG bolt for these two conditions. Okay. So, let us calculate the shear capacity of bolt for the first condition, that is slip resistance is designed at service load. So the first condition is given to calculate the design shear capacity of the HSFG bolt or the slip resistance of HSFG bolt is if slip resistance is designed at service load. Okay, so this is our first condition, and this condition is generally for the parallel shank type of HSFG bolt. As in case of parallel shank type of HSFG bolt, these bolts are designed for no slip condition at service load. Okay, so this is the condition of a parallel shank type of HSFG bolt. We have to first calculate the design shear capacity of the HSFG bolt or the slip resistance or the frictional resistance of the HSFG bolt for this condition. Okay. So, the design shear capacity of bolt the design shear capacity of HSFG bolt is denoted by VDSF, which can be calculated by the nominal shear capacity of the HSFG bolt divided by gamma MF. Okay, so here the value of gamma MF is 1.1, because to get the value of the gamma MF there are two conditions. One condition is if the slip resistance is designed at service load, then the gamma MF value is 1.1, and if the slip resistance is designed at ultimate load, then the value of gamma MF is 1.25. Okay. So, as here the condition is the slip resistance is designed at service load, so for that condition only the gamma MF the value is 1.1. Okay. So, then calculate the nominal shear capacity of HSFG bolt. Okay. So, the nominal shear capacity of HSFG bolt can be calculated by the formula, that is mu F into Ne into KH into F naught. Okay. So, here mu F is the coefficient of friction or the slip factor, and that value is given in the question directly. That value is 0.3. Okay. Then Ne is the number of surfaces which is offering the frictional resistance to slip. Okay. So, for the double cover bolt joint, there are two surfaces which are giving the frictional resistance to slip. So, for the double cover bolt joint, the value of Ne is 2. Then KH, for the KH, the condition is given that the fasteners are in clearance hole. So, for that condition the value of KH is 1. Then F naught. F naught is the minimum bolt tension at the time of installation. So, here the F naught can be calculated by F naught into A and B. Okay. So, here the A and B is the net area of the bolt, that is calculated by 0.78 into pi by 4 into D square, and here this small F naught is the proof stress, and that is the 70% of the ultimate tensile strength of bolt. Okay. So, here this small F naught is 0.7, that is the 70% of ultimate tensile strength of the bolt, and here A and B is 0.78 into pi by 4 into D square. Okay. So, here mu F is 0.3 So for the double cover board joint, the value of NE is 2, then KS is 1, then F naught is 0.7 into FUB. FUB, that value we got from the property class of the bolt, that is 8.8. okay, so the value of FUB is 800. Then next, 0.78 into pi by 4 into d square. So the diameter of bolt is given in the question, that is 20 mm. So nominal shear capacity of the HSFG bolt, this value is coming 82,332 newton, and this value you can write in kilonewton also, that is 82.332 kilonewton, as 1 newton is 1 newton is equal to 10 to the power minus 3 kilonewton. Okay, so the value of VNSF, that is the nominal shear capacity of the HSFG bolt, this value is coming 82.332 kilonewton. Then calculate the design shear capacity of the HSFG bolt. So here the design shear capacity of HSFG bolt is nominal shear capacity of bolt, that value has come, that is 82.332 kilonewton divided by gamma mf, that value is 1.1, and this value is coming 74.85 kilonewton. Okay, so this is the design shear capacity or the slip resistance of HSFG bolt for this condition, that is slip resistance, when slip resistance is designed at service load. Okay, then the next condition is when the slip resistance is designed at ultimate load. For this condition, the value of nominal shear capacity of HSFG bolt will be same, okay, but the value of gamma mf will be different, as for this condition the value of gamma mf is 1.25. so the design shear capacity of HSFG bolt can be calculated by nominal shear capacity of HSFG bolt divided by gamma mf. Okay, so here the nominal shear capacity of bolt that we have already calculated, that is 82.332 kilonewton divided by gamma mf, this value is 1.25. so this value is coming 65.86 kilonewton. okay, so in this way we can calculate the design shear capacity for the conditions, that is when the slip resistance is designed at the ultimate load and when the slip resistance is designed at the service load. And this condition is for wasted shank type of HSFG bolt. As in this type of bolts, the bolts are designed for the no slip condition at ultimate load. Okay, so this much all about today's class. In the next lecture we will solve a design problem related to high strength friction grip bolted joint. Thank you.